I love looking at a new bike, especially when it's from a new brand, or at least a brand that's new to me. Recently, Reid Bikes reached out for me to review one of their mountain bikes. Now, I hope I get this right, because the way I understand it, Reid is a brand that's known in Australia, but they now have bikes available in the US via their reidbikesusa.com website. And the review bike they sent is their Mountain Bike Disc Pro. And per their website, this bike comes in multiple frame sizes. They sent me a medium, which is a 43 centimeter or 17 inches. Now, they don't show any geometry specs, but there is a sizing guide. And that says this frame's a bit small for me, but I usually ride 17 to 18 inch frames, so we'll see. One curious note is they show two colors for this model, but neither look like the color they sent me. Maybe they haven't updated the pictures, but mine is a different gray-blue combo. Now, the site does have a bit of component info, like this has a 100mm front suspension, Shimano trigger shifters, disc brakes, and whatever oversized alloy bars are. The stem is listed as oversized too. But I found the stem to be a standard 80mm that fits a 1 1/8 inch steer, and the oversized bars, those are 31.8 diameter by 720mm. The listed mountain bike rubber grips are slip-ons, and the Shimano trigger shifters are Tourney TX Easy Fires, with a 3-speed selector on the left and an 8-speed on the right. And to keep it trendy, they equipped it with a trail belt. And from the website, we already know that this suspension fork has 100mm of travel, and it also has a remote lockout. And I see Reid graphics on the branding, but on the back side there's a sticker, and I can see that this is a Zoom fork. It's a 565 model, which, if my research is correct, means it has 25.4mm stanchions. Pinelli or Pinelli tires, I'm not familiar with this brand, maybe it's common in Australia, but these are 27.5 by 2.10. The wheels are double wall alloy and they're Reid branded, and the hubs are listed somewhat generically as alloy disc specific. The disc brakes themselves, though, they're not generic. Tektro mechanicals with 160mm rotors, and these are equipped on both the front and the rear. Pedal wise, these are cheap plastic looking, kind of blocky and boxy, all the words I don't want to hear in combo, but I don't know, maybe they'll surprise me. The 170mm alloy crank arms are marked TOL, another brand I'm not familiar with, and this 3x, it's a standard stamped and riveted, but it doesn't have that cheap gloss. Front shifting is taken care of by a Tourney front derailleur, a matching Tourney TX for the rear shifting, which is apparently popular with bees. The Mountain Bike Disc Pro shuns a freewheel in favor of a Shimano 8-speed cassette, and in this case it's a 12-32 tooth. 6061 aluminum for the frame, a frame that's nicely welded and beautifully colored, with gray graphics on a satin blue finish. And the frame styling, the top tube is round, with a down tube that's contoured and angled, it gives the bike a slightly different look. The seat post is 31.6mm diameter, and the saddle's unbranded. It has a relief groove, so I'll see how comfortable it is. So my first impressions, mostly positive. Now, the boxing didn't do the front wheel any justice. I had to have that trued before I could ride it, but everything else was acceptably well set up right out of the box. Even the brakes were good, and I say were because as soon as I got to the trail, I knocked the bike over and hit the rotor on a rock, so that rubbing that you're going to hear throughout this first ride, well, that's on me. It's something I'll fix later. Ride-wise, I usually have a good idea what to expect because I know most of these components, but I think because this is an Australian brand, I had some sort of mental block. So I started out ultra cautious, trying to get a feel for the bike. Right away, I could say that the sizing, at least on their side, is a bit off. Because this is a medium frame, it's supposed to fit riders up to 5'8". Well, I'm 5'10", and this is just right for me. Maybe it's that oversized bars and stem, but this suits me pleasantly well. So it only took one quick loop on the warm-up trail, and I'm ready for the main trail. Now, I always complain about climbing, and I'm also not in peak trail shape. But at 32 pounds, with this 3x8 setup, I was able to quite easily work my way up the slow, steady incline that is the trail entrance. I even took the long way, made it to the top rest bench in better shape than I would have expected, and even came across one of the few riders I saw throughout our hot summer with his YT full suspension. Acceleration is also good, meaning those disc-specific hubs must also be well lubricated. And let me stress that what you're seeing here, aside from a front wheel true, is an out-of-the-box experience because I didn't adjust anything and it shifts out perfectly. So far, I know this climbs well. It accelerates okay, though it's not a racer by any stretch, and it feels quite nimble on the trail. Even those oddly named tires, they're okay when it comes to grip, at least for what this bike is. That front suspension though, that Zoom fork, I mean, it's not big box, it's better than that, but it is, well, on the rattly side. Because it not only rattles me, but it rattles itself at points, even enough to ring its own bell. And that's while going slow, which is where I think this is really at its best. A beginner bike able to tackle entry-level mountain bike trails that lets a new rider have some fun and test out the sport. Meaning this isn't for people that like to ride hard or push a bike to its limits. I think if you took a Trek 820 and mixed it with a GT Aggressor Pro, you would end up with this, something spec similar to the Trek Marlin 4. Making it firmly an entry-level mountain bike. But along with the beautiful finish, which has received compliments from everyone that's seen it, people have thought that this was a local bike shop bike. Now I'm assuming that some of that is the unfamiliarity with the Reid brand in the US, but I think also part of it speaks to the visual quality of the bike. And for me, the medium frame and the stated oversized bars and stem fit me incredibly well. And the Easy Fire trigger shifter's rock solid, yes, but not a standout feature on a bike that's $480. And those mountain bike rubber grips, not comfortable at all, and one of the two things on the bike will definitely change before riding it again. The Tektro mechanical discs not only stopped the bike well, but worked perfect out of the box. And even after smacking one of the rotors on a rock, still rideable. And these wheels and tires, I would rate okay. And the tires are very soft and have flexible sidewalls, so note that. That Zoom fork, it does an okay job considering this is a very beginner mountain bike, but it's not going to scale up, well really, any. So far I've only disliked the grips, that's until I get to these pedals, which are easily the most slippery I've ever ridden. Zero traction, and at one point my foot shot off like I'd stepped in grease and almost created a crash. Plus they're so tall, unnecessarily thick, I don't like these at all. The rest of the crankset though, no problems at all, and free spinning too, so there must be good bearings in that sealed bottom bracket. And being a cassette instead of a freewheel, that opens up a lot of future options. And the seats, not bad at all, admittedly more comfortable than I expected it to be. Overall, after my first ride, I think this is a nicely built bike and an attractive beginner mountain bike and equipped comparable for its price if comparing it to local bike shop bikes. And that's not factoring in bike shop setup and service, so I think for this bike to get a foothold in a crowded US market, it's either going to need to cost less or come with slightly more upscale components like maybe a Shimano Altus drivetrain. But after riding it, I can say this is a good looking and well built bike, but what do you think? Let me know by commenting below, and also, have you ever heard of Reid bikes? I hope you subscribe if you haven't already and that everyone has the notification bell active, and if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching and have a great day.